to qualitatively analyze an unknown inorganic compound for the cationic constituents in a solution, the solution is treated with various reagents that may cause characteristic reactions and lead to color changes, precipitate, or gas formation. Because some cations do not give a color when subjected to a flame, they are dissolved in water to produce a solution. Here we shall test for the presence of aluminium, iron 3+, copper, iron 2+, cobalt, nickel, ammonium, manganese, and silver by the addition of ammonium chloride and ammonium hydroxide solutions. Before beginning, record your initial observations. The observed reactions consist of color changes and precipitates forming in the solution on addition of ammonium chloride and ammonium hydroxide solution. These changes indicate the presence or absence of the desired cation. Here we have our unknown solutions, and to these we shall add 3 drops of our ammonium chloride and 5 drops of ammonium hydroxide. The observed reactions will indicate either the presence or absence of our desired cation. To our unknown solution A, a clear solution, we shall add in 3 drops of our ammonium chloride and 5 drops of the ammonium hydroxide. The observed reaction from clear solution forming a cloudy precipitate may be an indication of the aluminium cation. To our unknown solution B, which is yellow in color, we shall add in our 3 drops of the ammonium chloride and 5 drops of the ammonium hydroxide. This forms a brown precipitate. This gives us an indication of the iron 3+ cation. To our unknown solution C, which is blue in color, we add our 3 drops of the ammonium chloride and 5 drops of the ammonium hydroxide. This forms a blue precipitate, and upon shaking, the solution becomes cloudy. To our unknown solution D, which is clear in color, we shall add in our 3 drops of the ammonium chloride and 5 drops of the ammonium hydroxide. This forms a blue-green precipitate. Because of this, we suspect the iron 2+ cation. To our unknown solution E, which is pink in color, we add in 3 drops of the ammonium chloride and 5 drops of the ammonium hydroxide. This forms a blue precipitate, which gives us an indication of the cobalt cation. To our unknown solution F, which is green in color, we add in 3 drops of the ammonium chloride and 5 drops of the ammonium hydroxide solution. This forms a blue clear solution. We can suspect the nickel cation. To our unknown solution G, which is clear in color, we add in 3 drops of the ammonium chloride and 5 drops of the ammonium hydroxide. The unknown solution remains clear, hence we can suspect the ammonium cation. To our unknown solution H, which is clear in color, we add in 3 drops of the ammonium chloride and 5 drops of the ammonium hydroxide. This forms a yellow-brown precipitate. We can suspect the manganese cation. To our unknown solution I, which is clear in color, we add in 3 drops of the ammonium chloride and 5 drops of the ammonium hydroxide. This forms a white precipitate. We can suspect the silver cation.